Hey, Frank, I thought this was pretty cool. I got this from our friend Johnny Fowler. He has a loan officer working for him. His name's Nick Smallwood.
Okay.
And check this out. It says, love the shout out. Already have 5 agents signed up and 14 leads in less than 24 hours. He just got his listing booster account.
In 24
5
hours.
Agents, 14 leads in 24 hours.
There you go.
And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Beth. She said, holy crap, just put one of my listings active on Listing Booster 5 minutes ago, and I have a showing at 4 and 2 others scheduled. Thank you, Greg.
Hmm.
Greg, of course, responded like a good loan officer should.
Mm-hmm.
Holy smokes, Beth Ann, great job. Jonathan Fowler, you see this? Hashtag boom! So if you don't have Listing Booster in the stagnant market that we have right now, I sure hope you got a solution. If not, you better click this banner right over there on Facebook. It is straight up above. And now, by the way, on with Feedback Friday.
1, 2, 3, 4! Talk about what you say! Feedback Friday! Talk about what you say on Feedback Friday!
Last week, we did a show on Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac becoming utilities.
Right.
On top of Fannie and Freddie becoming utilities, offering very similar products to what they have right now, the private sector would also be welcome to come in and join and create their own utilities to compete against Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac.
Will Looper, loan officer at Movement Mortgage, says, so what does this mean for interest rates if Fannie and Freddie become a utility? Do rates end up being more uniform across the board? Question mark. Hey, what do you think?
Well, that's kind of the idea here. As we said before, you may not understand this, but prior to going into conservatorship, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac had different deals with different companies. Mm. The larger the company, the better the deal it was for them. So it stands to reason the likes of Wells Fargo, Chase, Citi, and Bank of America had better deals, were paying less in G-fee, and had more favorable underwriting conditions. The reason we're going down this road by dismantling Fannie and Freddie and making them utilities is so that we can save the precious 30-year fixed rate mortgage. The idea behind this is yes, we will have more uniform pricing, and all fingers crossed, pricing will remain competitive and possibly even lower.
Great response. Okay, we also did an interview with Carl Markham with Remen Wholesale, and with respect to that interview, one of our viewers, Joseph J. Longobardi, I hope I said that right,
Longobardi,
from Phoenix, Maryland, says this, lake is shrinking a bit, same amount of fishermen. Keep casting, get all your lines out, make sure your outriggers are out, and make sure there are no holes in your nets. Perfect your process. If you don't fish, I'm saying to get all of your avenues of business operating and referring business. Did you take time this year to personally write thank yous to your past clients and ask them to remember you? No, not an email, handwritten thank you notes. My grandmother always and still does get upset if you don't write a thank you. Did you make money today? And that, of course, we were talking about doing a sales blitz with Carl Markham from Remen.
You know, the whole thing in here that really stuck to me, love the metaphors about the fishing stuff, but what really stuck to me, what a great question for a loan officer to ask himself at the end of every day.
True.
Did you make money today?
Yeah, that's true.
Did your efforts actually, in fact, make you money today?
Right.
And answer that honestly.
Yeah.
And if you didn't, you need to have a solution for the following day. Here's a great tip for every loan officer and real estate agent out there right now. And boy, this one rings true and it's simple. Ask yourself and honestly respond. Did your efforts that you put in today, in fact, make you money? If not, change it. We did a show on what we saw were the pitfalls of trended credit. Helen Sagi replied, I've always thought that credit for a mortgage should be based on secured debt payment history only, cars, houses, boats, etc. As a mortgage markets investor, I'd prefer you to not make that $35 revolving credit card payment so you can make your mortgage payment. It shows you understand which is more important. As for trended credit, why not go back all the way to the early 1990s and give interest rate based on credit history? You know, credit worthiness. This nonsense of everyone getting the same rate is ludicrous. In 1991, my husband and I bought our first house. We got a 9% interest rate. Yes, it impacted on how much we could buy, but then again, it should. We hadn't been homeowners yet. Fast forward to now, and we qualify for the lowest rates because we demonstrated how to pay a mortgage. That makes more sense to me. Here's the deal on this one, guys. And this is a pretty interesting banter back and forth that we're not gonna get into. People did have different interest rates in the 1990s, but here's the deal. Those were generally lender overlays. Now, when you're talking about your FHA and your VA stuff, Jenny doesn't have any overlays. Those overlays are put on by lenders, and it stands to reason. The riskier the profile of the borrower, the higher the risk to the lender, so I think it should have a higher yield. So I'm agreeing with the statement. What about you, Frank?
Well, I don't know if you can just rate someone on installment payments alone with getting a mortgage. I don't think that that tells the whole picture.
Sure.
You know, and I don't think that necessarily means that if they made their car payment loan and their personal loan payments and their, you know, their installment loan payments that they jacked up on their credit card, et cetera, I don't think that necessarily means that, they're gonna be okay on the mortgage.
Right.
I just don't think that's, I don't agree with it.
Well, I don't agree with that part. I agree with you on that.
Yeah.
But people did, in fact, have different interest rates back then.
Yeah, they did.
On the same show, Stephen Brand, who is a loan officer at Hancock Mortgage and is also an instructor at Military Mortgage Bootcamp, says, good stuff today. Was there a subliminal Wizard of Oz message there when you moved from black and white to color that was oddly right at the same time you mentioned FHFA? The shift from black and white to color was when Dorothy moved from Kansas to the make-believe world of Oz, right? So does Oz equal FHA? Now, here's what I want to tell you. This is very, very observant of Mr. Brand here. You notice that we also mentioned the person behind the green curtain. So yes, we very much had a Wizard of Oz back and forth theme. For everybody else who didn't catch it, here's what I have to say. Yeah, we do put that much time into our shows. So forward them!
And we also did a show about the CFPB not going after Equifax. And the credit guy submitted a comment to us, and he says this. The CFPB going after Equifax is like a bully spitting on a kid that was already beat up. The info that was hacked is starting to be used in interesting ways, though.
Well, that's a perfect analogy. Maybe a bit, you know, crass, but it's the perfect analogy. Equifax does not want to be hacked. Equifax wants to fix their problems.
Sure.
Having the CFPB tie them up in lawsuits for years and charge them hundreds of millions of dollars is not going to help them fix the problem any more than they're already going to do. Frankly, if anything, it's going to slow them down. So the analogy of spitting in the kid's face who already had his ass kicked makes perfect sense to me, credit guy.
And that was the point of your show, really.
It was.
Yeah. So there you go. What's next?